Hello again, YouTube. It's JeremyX here with my trusty co-host, Aaron.
Hello, guys. Glad to be back.
And here we have Yu-Gi-Oh! Invasion Vengeance Unwrapping.
All right, now we got to get a little background to this. Okay, first off, we were waiting a while to do this because Amazon... No, it was eBay.
Yes,
eBay
it was eBay.
Being a pain in the rear to send it in. And I suggested, hey, man, open a couple packs just to make sure you didn't get ripped off because I don't trust eBay.
When I got the package, it didn't have the box. It just had these packs in two rubber bands. So I opened the packs and show them what we got.
Well, I kind of took some for myself because this is one of the prime reasons we're getting this is because I'm building stuff around this archetype, the ciphers. In the Arc V anime, this is what Kaito uses in place of photons in galaxies. And I'm trying to make a character deck for it because ciphers look really fun to play.
And he also got a super heavy soul samurai and a nine
super heavy pose. Samurai soul whatever. We'll do it in. But yeah, we got two cipher bits from this. Thank you, buddy, by the way.
The new Yang Xing
counter trap. I'm hoping we also pull their synchro tuner because I'm actually pretty excited for flavor reasons that that Stardust Yang Xing might be a possibility.
Mm-hmm.
We got the super heavy samurai soul peacemaker. I'll read what he does in a bit. He's probably a good addition.
Aroma Seraphy Angelica.
Yeah, I can't really read upside down.
Predaplant Moray Nepenthes.
Which is the main villain. It's the main villain of the Fusion Dimensions archetype, by the way. Crystallic Potential,
Teller Knight Genesis, super rare. Flower Cardian, Maple with Deer.
Ignite Unite.
Criston Thistvern. Canine Tar. Paleozoic Demuscius. Chemicritter Oxyox.
I'm gonna go ahead and make my complaints that they should have made more Crystal Beasts instead of giving them a new archetype because we need more Crystal Beast support. By the way, America still doesn't have those pendulums.
Yeah, that stinks.
Yeah, it really does, because I love Crystal Beasts. Crystal Beasts is one of my first decks I ever made.
Super rare Subterra Behemoth Stega Kraken.
Now, these guys, like, for their playstyle, is really cool with their flavor. What they do is they're all flip monsters, and they do something when they flip, because they're basically emerging out of the sea, the ground, whatever. And their other support resets them back down so you can do it again. So I think it's just really cool and flavorful how they do that.
Absolutely.
Another Predaplant card.
Squid Dracera.
Drosera, yeah.
Pandora's Jewelry Box.
Why does that look like it works with Performer Pals? Oh, it doesn't. It's just generic. And then...
Rare Metal Foes Bismagear.
I don't see why they changed the Japanese name from Metal Phosis, because it like Metal and Metamorphosis.
Yeah,
sounds cool.
Yeah.
Why did they make it Metal Foes?
Why they change Machine to Mechlord?
Mechlord does sound cooler, I'll admit, in my opinion.
Eh. Fair enough. All right, let's get to this.
I'm trying to build a cipher deck, and the reason I'm going to be unboxing this entire thing is because my buddy here forgot his tripod. He was in a rush, but we've been trying to schedule this for so dang long. It's just been a pain. But I'm going to be unable to make the cipher deck really good until Raging Tempest comes out in February, which I'm really excited for. Because that gives me the last of the regular cipher monster supports, the Neo Galaxy Eyes Cipher Dragon, and the first of the rank ups.
All right, let's see what we got here.
We got Mare, Canine Tar, Flower Cardian Peony with Butterfly,
Saber Reflection for the rare.
They got a reprint in this set?
I remember
this in the video games, man. This thing was a pain.
Another Teller Knight Genesis, Criston Thistvern, Criston Praise Tortle, Performa Pal Changerath, and Chemicritter Carbo Crab.
Still so upset that they did not just make more Crystal Beasts.
Dude.
Actually, I think it's the end of this month or next. We're getting the Destiny Soldier set with that really broken Dark Angel card. That's why Kaiser Coliseum got banned, because it made a lock. Didn't think the meta did that anymore. So go control all over again, man.
Let's see.
Predaplant.
Predaplant Morant Nephesis. Crystallic Potential. Mare. Double Cypher.
Yeah, that's an okay one. I think.
And we got Burnout.
Hello.
And whoa, Dark Knight Battlemus for our
Dark
ultra,
Teller Knight. Yes.
Dark Teller Knight for our ultra rare.
Huh. Sprite's Blessing, Ignites Unite, and Crystron Entry.
Very nice. Very
Dark
nice.
Tellers,
all.
That's a thing now. Oh no. The Shadows took over the Teller Knights. We're in trouble. And if you guys didn't know, there was actually the whole dual terminal thing had an ongoing storyline, and they're continuing it with these cards. Shadowballs were what was left of the freaking evil swarm.
Well, you might know it, but people like me.
I didn't know until a buddy of mine pointed it out. Anyway, next pack. Chemicritter, Onyx, Ox. I'm sorry. Former pal, Seal Eel. Crystron.
Rosenix.
Okay, I will admit the Crystrons look kind of cool.
And Flower Cardian, Bordafly. Paleozoic, Obane for our super rare. Performer pal, Chain Giraffe. Paleozoic and Eldonia. Another rare from Metaphos, Bismagear, and Doki Doki. Doki.
Hello, Doki Doki, what do you do? Oh, okay. Interesting. I mean, between this and the Dragons of Legend, you can make a complete, just, there's so much support for Flower Cardians all of a sudden.
Yeah.
Alright, what we're getting here is, ooh, hello, alien support, it's been a bit. A-cell recombination device.
Ooh, and very nice.
Crystron
Smiger.
Oh, Crystron.
Crystron Rosenix, another Aroma Seraphy Angelica, Performa Pal Wimwitch for our rare, Spiral Master Plan for our super rare, Rare Metaphos Bismagear,
another Cypher Bit,
and Flower Cardian Maple with Deer. So now you have a full three set of Cypher Bit.
Come on, Knights and Raptors. And I believe...
I say come on rare, come on the Venom,
they do
Venom Fusion Dragon.
Crystron Impact. I think these might have something to do with the gem.
I mean, like, I opened one pack of Dark Illusion about a week ago, and I pulled a Nirvana High Paladin.
Yeah, too bad you can't really use one in your build anyway. Crystron Rosenix again. Psyframe Multi-Threader.
Subterra Behemoth Burrowing for our rare.
That's what flips him back down, by the way.
Crystron Kron for our super rare.
Okay, I'll look into Crystrons, I suppose.
Predaplant Squind Rosera.
Present card.
Inks Kareebon.
Oh, that's mean. Your opponent discards their entire hand and draws five cards.
So it's like card destruction, but only for them. That's
And it's in trap form. Oh, man.
Flower Cardian Maple with Deer and Summon Gate.
Pretty sure that's been here before. Anyway, next pack. You know, for the Cyphers being commons, we only pulled bits and doubles.
This would be technically pack 8 out of 24. Mm-hmm. We got Chemicritter Oxyox,
Psyframe
Multithreader, Crystron Impact, Flower Cardian Clover with Boar, Spiral Mission Assault for our rare, Torque Tune Gear for our super rare, Chemicritter Carbo Crab, Drizera, and another Pandora's Jewelry Box.
I'm sitting here waiting on someone. Psyframe Multithreader,
Crystron Impact, Flower Cardian Clover with Boar, Predaplane Flytrap for our rare, Subterra Behemoth Sticker Kraken for our super rare, Crystron Entry.
Gradle Slide Jr., yay! I love Gradle Kaiju so much. It's such a fun deck to play, especially versus Super Quannels. It's just fun. I might actually take that.
And he's talking this to the guy who actually wants to build a Super Quantal deck.
We're building you that eventually.
Yes. Crystron Praise Tortle and Paleozoic Morella. Oh, wait, what's this?
Yeah, they're the archetype trap monsters.
Paleozoic Obania for a super rare.
Yep.
Somewhere along the way. Anyways, here we go.
Sorry, I'm kind of tunnel visioned on the commons, ironically.
Yes.
Crystron Rosenix, Psyframe Multithreader, Chemicritter Ox.
Perform Pal Seal Eel.
Hello, Sarutobi! I love Super
Heavy Samurai Ninja Sarutobi for our rare.
They're a really unique playstyle, and the best feeling is watching your opponent rage as you get rid of their Mirror Force and take it for yourself.
Oh, nice.
Oh, that's not from this. That was
look at this. True King Barastos, the Fathomer, for our ultra rare.
That was listed. I think he's the enemy against the Crystron, the Crystron, because he's shown on Crystron Entry. In fact, let me get him out of here. No, not Crystron Entry. Move Pele's up. Where are you? There we go. Crystron Impact. See?
Yeah, I see. There he is. Yeah. Anyways, our
final. This guy's really cool. He's a worm type. That's really good. He almost looks like he has the Kawaki Maru imprint on his head. I'll look into him in a minute. Anyway, we got Dino Sewing, Performer Pal Flip Hippo. I'm tired of the hippos, man. That's the one thing I do not like in RPGs.
Targets on hippos!
Psyframe Accelerator. Alright, the Psyframes are getting some decent support. It's been a while since I've seen them. Alright. Alright, we got Paleozoic.
Paleozoic Dynamiscus.
I would be able to pronounce this if I could see it. Ooh.
Performer Pal Seal Eel. Chemical Oxyox,
Red Ice Con,
Sights, Tectonic Tune Gear, and wait, hold on, Cypher, another Cypher bit. Flower Carney Maple with Deer, Sprite's Blessing, and Ignites Unite.
Let me read this Red Eyes card because I'm really glad that Red Eyes, Blue Eyes, and Dark Magician got support because we've been wanting to build, everyone's been wanting to build decks around them since, you know, the start of the game. They just couldn't keep up. There was no, because they weren't fun to play because they couldn't keep up, etc. Now, where'd my Cyphers go? I'll dig them out in a minute.
There's your Cyphers right there.
Oh, yeah, I had a fourth, we had a fourth one. I actually kind of need that fourth one because, where'd it go?
And here's your Yangzing.
Yeah, that's for a buddy of mine. But I'm also going to try the Cypher bits out in my galaxies because they work well with that as well. Where'd it go? I just had it. Hang on. Did I mix it up here? Here it is. All right. Let me read this Red Eyes insight here. Send one Red Eyes monster from your hand or deck to the graveyard. Add one Red Eyes spell or trap from your deck to your hand, except Red Eyes insight. You can only activate one Red Eyes insight per turn. That's not bad. Helps you get that... Because they're very reliant on their stone, which hallelujah got a reprint in the legendary decks.
Oh, and they're yes, really absolutely. Reliant.
Yeah, the two core cards that were running upwards of $50. No card.
I was also super happy that Red Eyes Black Flare got a reprint. Came in
the, like Black Flare, freaking it's I can't remember the name of it because it got changed in English, but it's the level 4 effect type that
Red Eyes Wyvern.
No, not Wyvern. It's a dark type. It was a Tracer in the original Japanese.
Oh.
But it finally got its English printing. Mare. Great old combat. I'll have to look in that in a second. Chemicritter, Hydron Hawk. Chemicritters!
Control yourself, man. Another Nine Pillars of Yangzing.
I hate them so much!
Another Nine Pillars of Yangzing.
Let's go into a buddy.
Pot of Acquisitiveness for our super rare.
Finally! It's Cypher Mirror Knight.
Cypher Mirror Knight. Awesome!
Then
Sprite's Blessing and Polychemicritter High Dragon.
Okay, I'll give them a chance. I'll look into them, but I'm still so upset about that.
It's very...
Target 3 banished. Ooh. Pot of Acquisitiveness. This works really well. Oh my god, this is Shiranui Gold.
Let me see this.
Target 3 banished monsters, shuffle all 3 into deck, then draw 1 card. You can only activate 1 a turn, but it's that quick play. Buddy, ooh, I'm actually also building Shiranui, and this is...
Very nice.
That's a godsend. Holy crap. Because they banish their monsters a lot, and if you don't have a way to get them back in the deck to cycle it, you're kind of done. Another reason I'm excited for Raging Tempest is the other Shiranui cards.
I know.
Oh, we're getting their biggest boss monster.
Pack 13.
All right. Cypher Twin Raptor.
Awesome.
Chemicritter Hydron Hawk. I swear I'll give you guys a chance.
Great old combat.
Charming Resort Staff. It's one of the spirals. And look, Spiral Resort. What are the odds? What are the odds?
Yeah.
Chemicritter.
Cartel Crab. Drissa. Jewelry Box. And Bismagear.
Sorry, I'm a little fumbling it. I should be.
Yeah, like.
Steady.
No, it's alright.
Great old combat. I'm looking at that. I'm looking at the
great
old
stuff. What? It's just YouTube.
I mean, there are a lot of people who do it, like, they do this for, like, a living, man. I want to at least look like I know what I'm doing. I know I'm not a professional.
Well, come on, we're just in our earliest days.
Ah, yeah, I know. But, you know, first impressions do count. And by the way, thank you guys for watching. If he hasn't said it yet, I will. This is my first YouTube experience where these past few videos, and it's starting to grow on me a little bit. So, I haven't read the comments yet because I've been really busy, but I'm hoping to get a glimpse of them. Anyway. Create a plant, Mori Nepenthes, sorry. Again, upside down reading is a pain.
No, let me read them. Flower Cardian with Clover with Boar.
Yeah,
Cypher Twin
three.
Raptor, awesome,
two
another
three.
One. Kristen Smiger, Dragon Core Hexer for our rare, Paleozoogalbunnia.
Did I see him like on the list or something?
For our super rare, no. Kriston Entry, Predaplant Squid Drosera, and Present Card.
Interesting.
But seriously, I didn't think we'd see another normal tune again, much less a level 8 one.
Yeah, and I think it has something to do with the Draco Slayers by lore. Again,
I missed those. Let's see. We got 8 packs.
I missed Draco Slayers. Those things were busted.
Let's see. This would be 24 minus 8. This would be pack number 16. Let's see what we got here.
Ooh. Sorry, I went ahead of myself.
A-Cell Recombination Device, Kriston Smiger, Kriston Resenix, Performer Pal Wim Witch for our rare, the Phantom Knights Rank Up Magic Launch for
Phantom
our super
Knights.
Rare.
They're so cool. They're in the Arc V, they're Yuya's, his Dark Ixies Dimension Counterparts archetype.
Yes.
And they're also his, the Dark Yuya in the mangas. Like, his deck just mid-game will switch to Phantom Knights if he goes that.
Cyframe Accelerator, another Cypher Mirror Knight.
2-3.
Polychemicritter Hydreigon and Chemicritter Carbocrab.
Right, so that's... I need one more Twin Raptor, one more Mirror Knight, and I guess I can work with Double Cyphers. Again, I'm not going to be making them until February, but I actually have a buddy who might be one because he loves Phantom Knights.
Let's see, that's...
Dude, because the Phantom Knights go with Dark Veil and Xyz.
We are now unpacking.
By the way, Dark Veil and Xyz rank up as a thing in here, but it's a Dark Requiem Xyz Dragon. Paleozoic whatever.
Paleozoic Dynamiscus. Perform Pal Seal Eel. Chemicritter Oxyox. Cyframe Multithreader. Constellar Tempest for our rare. Crystal Quan for our super rare. Flower Cardi Maple with Deer. Sprite's Blessing. And Ignites Unite.
And I still can't wait for Raging Tempest.
Down to our last
Also,
eight
I'm
packs.
Really glad that Destiny Heroes, as broken as they're about to be, I'm glad they're finally getting support because they were always just like a sub-theme throughout the entire thing.
Pack number 17. We got Mare.
Oh, yeah, that's the...
Another Double Cypher!
Yay, I may or may not use that because it's situational as
hell. Cyframe Multithreader. Space Dragster for our rare.
Okay, that's really cool looking.
Oh, tell me about it. Torque Tune Gear for our super rare. Dino Sewing. Flower Stacking, Criston Thistvern, and Sprite's Blessing.
I hope we pull... We're getting a lot of these Sprite's Blessing. I hope we pull the secret rare freaking ritual that goes with them. Hello.
Quarantine, Paleozoic Linkoilla, Fraud Free, so I remember that guy.
Hey, Dark Bribe Dude!
Yeah, I was thinking Dark Bribe Dude. Quilf's End for our rare.
Cleef's End, actually.
Yeah, whichever. Vola Chemicritter Methadraco for our super rare. Sprite's Blessing. Perform a Pal Flip Hippo. Summon Gate. And.
Change Giraffe.
Change Giraffe.
Okay, roll up. Actually. Okay, I'm going to give the Chemicritters a look because that does look kind of cool. Vola Chemicritter Methadraco. He's a Beast Warrior. Why would you call him Draco if he's a Beast Warrior? Okay. All right.
We're down to our 18th pack.
Canine Tar.
Canine Tar. Paleozoic Dynamiscus. Chemicritter Oxyox. Flower Cardian Clover with Boar. Dragon Core Hexer for our rare. Cyber Angel Vrash for our super rare. Cyframe Accelerator. Cypher Mirror Knight.
Woo! 3.
And Polychemicritter Hydreigon.
Oh, but these guys do use Geminis, though. Where's my Mirror Knight? I need one more Raptor.
Well, it's a Machine Angel ritual, but still, it works.
Oh, I mean, do you not know what all we pulled in Dragons Unleashed, buddy? Do you not have that on you, by the way?
No, I don't.
Oh, well, because we'll do that in a minute. Anyway, we'll sort this all out in a minute. Another Fraud Freeze.
Fraud Freeze. Crystallic Potential. Predaplant Morinephysis.
Oh, I think I like what I'm seeing.
Double Cypher.
Yeah.
Aroma Seraphy Rosemary. Criston Quandax for an Ultra Rare.
Yeah!
Chemicritter Carbocrab, Flower Carding Maple with Deer, and Ignites Unite.
Okay, fine. I'll give these guys a look. I'm honestly, I've kind of overlooked a lot of stuff in this pack because I was just gunning for...
I know. Pack number 21. Let's see.
Into the nitty-gritty.
Criston Smiger, Amazing Pendulum, Paleozoic Dynamiscus.
Oh, dude, this one could be used in your deck like right now. If you have no cards in your Pendulum Zone, add two face-up Magician Pendulum monsters with different names from your extra deck to your hand. You can only activate one per turn. That's nice.
Wow. Oop. Let's see. Polychemicritter Dioxogre for our rare. Full Metal Foes Fusion for our super rare. Paleozoic Marella. Dino Sewing. Flower Stacking. And Criston Thistvern.
Why you guys... Oh.
Down to our last three packs.
Smack for luck.
Yes.
I just need one more Twin Raptor for me. Because then I've got all the ciphers. I mean, more bits would be nice, but...
Amazing Pendulum.
Hey.
Paleozoic Dynamiscus. Quarantine. Paleozoic Lean Chililla. Meteor Dragon Red Eyes Impact for our rare. Criston Crete. Criston Citri for our super ultra rare. Flower Cardian Maeve with Deer. Summon Gate. And Performer Pal Change Giraffe. On our last two packs.
Yep.
Let's smack them for luck.
Oh, too late. Ugh. Well, good news. I got my last Twin Raptor.
Oh, yeah.
Predaplant.
If this. Flower Cardian Clover with Boar. Cypher Twin Raptor.
Thank you.
Super Koi Koi for our rare. Super Hemisticker Kraken for our super rare. Cypher Mirror Knight. Polychritter Hydreigon. Paleozoic Eldonia. And another Dracera.
Thank you. Right. Where'd that raptor go? Where'd it go? There it is. All right, last one. Please be a bombshell.
Are the cards guide us?
Mare.
Double cipher.
Still so situational.
Cyframe multi-threader. Space dragster for our rare. Criston Amatrix for our super rare. Flower stacking. Cypher Mirror Knight. Sprite's Blessing and Polychemic Critter
High Dragon. No bombshell. Oh well. Well, I believe we should start sorting stuff out. I will most likely omit the Cypher stuff because I'm going to hoard them like gold. Because fine, I've been waiting.
Yes, absolutely.
So I suppose give us a minute, and are we gonna bother sorting this one out, or?
Oh, let's just do it already.
Let's keep it tradition.
So, out of a 100-card expansion pack, we managed to grab 84 of them. A whopping 84!
Well, to be fair, the other, 16 were like Secrets and Ultimates and Ultras.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, a lot harder to get, but hey, I'm kind of happy with what we got. I mean, glad that Gradle's finally got a new tuner. They got me a little something. Cyber Angel just goes well with the other Cyber Angels we got. What I finally actually bothered to sit down and read was the Predaplants. These guys are actually kind of scary. What they do is, they're low-level dudes, but they put Predator counters on things, and if they were level 2 or higher, those things become level 1, and then they, like, gain the levels of the others, but they're not a synchro deck as, you know, level adjusting would be. They're made for the fusion, because they're one of the main bad guys of this arc of Arc V's deck. He's like the leader, one of the leaders of the fusion dimension. He uses the fusion dragon.
And speaking of alternate dimensions, we managed to pull for you 3 Cyber Twin Raptors and 5 Cypher Mirror Knights.
4 bits and 4 doubles.
4 double ciphers and 4 cipher bits.
I need 2 more because I want to try them out in my galaxy as well, because that's like, I was so worried that was going to be like an ultra or something, and I'm like, I need 6. But no, they're common. The only ones that are of any actual rarity that I've seen between the two lists are Cypher Wing at ultra rare, regular Cypher Dragon at secret rare, and I think ultra rare next pack ultra rare is going to be a Neo Cypher.
Yeah, but I gotta say, pulling not one, but 2 ultra rares.
This was also a pain to sort, I might add.
Oh, yeah. Well, actually, make that 3 ultra rares.
Yeah, that guy... Or,
no, 4, even.
This guy kind of reminds me, because with his effect, he works with water types. He destroys water types in your hand to do things, to summon himself. But when he does his thing, you can get a non-water worm type. I think these are the worm type versions of the Draco rulers. Yeah. Not the dragon rulers.
Yeah, I think any support
for the dragon rulers. This is like the water version of them.
Any support for the dragon rulers is a good one because...
No, it's not. This doesn't specifically support them. This is a new version of them.
Oh.
Because the dragon rulers are dragons. Yeah. These guys are worm types.
Well, hopefully they'll get less hit by the ban list, but then again...
Hopefully they'll actually be balanced, dude, because, like, when they were all at 3, the deck was impossible to beat.
Oh, yeah.
If they had just left the ore dragon type and just kept with the element, the attributes, they would have been fine.
But my personal favorites had to be these two right here. Space Dragster and Dragon Core Hexer, because haven't seen a normal tuner in a long time. And Space Dragster definitely looks like something Yusei would use. Even looks like
he might have. I don't know.
The Synchron face.
In the Synchro rings and everything. Yeah. Also, it's really good when you activate it, you just flip it up. This guy becomes a level 1 fire machine tuner, but when you he's still counted as a trap, but the turn you activate him, your tuners can't be destroyed by battle or card effects.
Yeah, so you can't. So your opponent can't blow up any tuners.
Which is great, because if you kind of run out of gas, because a lot of that really specifically helps out. The first big synchro Yusei did with Excel Synchro.
That was Shooting Star Dragon.
Shooting Quasar, actually.
That was like the Delta over Excel,
that's
over the
that's.
Limit synchro
yeah, that's
summon.
That's to help with that, because. That's how, because that's a big problem. If you ran out of gas playing like the small tuners and you did it, but you couldn't synchro then, they would just get rid of all your hard work and you'd be done.
Man, that was like Legendary Collection 5Ds, man.
That was a jump promo at first. I remember when that thing was $40.
Yeah, and then think, yeah, I always
and then
say
we had the infamous days of Lovell Quasar. Thank God that's not a thing anymore, because they just dropped two Quasars on you in one turn and you were done. But the Crystrons, they look like they're leftovers. I'm talking about the dual. Some of you might know what the dual terminal is here, but they look like they're the leftovers of some of the. I'm gonna say some of the Vylon bits with the Gem Knight bits, because both of them in the story kind of got screwed over.
I'm just like
they were, and the funny thing is they're crystalline in appearance like the Gem Knights, and they combine together like the Gem Knights, but they also synchro like the Vylons, and actually these guys also excel synchro just like the Yang Xing.
I personally like how we got the very first card in the set, Space Dragster, and the very last card in the set, Paleozoic Obanina.
Obanina. Yep. The Paleozoics are nice because back in the day, that was a fully thing with like the Tiki Idols, with Zoma the Spirit, and all those. Yes. And you know.
All the trap monsters,
yeah,
everything.
Now they have an actual archetype that works together, which is really cool. If only they'd bring back fossils.
Yeah, well, we can't have everything, thanks to Konami.
Oh, well, what they've given us is good enough. Like, this, right here, totally overlooked it. That thing, Pot of
Acquisitiveness.
That thing is just made for Shiranui, because they banished themselves so hard, and one of the main problems I had when playing them when they first came out was that they were really slow to get their banished monsters back, and they kind of lacked on the draw.
We may never get the old pots back, but the newer pots are a lot better than the other ones.
To be fair, the old pots are busted. And if you use them to be busted, the way you and I are going to use them is just to put gas on our little fun decks. Like, it literally is just... Like, for Slifer? I mean, otherwise Slifer's going to be really low attack, and what's the point of summoning him? And it also, it helps me get through, like, dead pockets, because I've got... Because I run a Hieratic Raw build. That's, like, the only level... monsters lower than level 5 I have are two Maiden with Eyes of Blue. Because I have a mix. I've got two blue eyes, two mages with eyes of blue. I run Azure Eyes. I have three Hieratic Dragon E sets, which are level 5s. Three Tefnut and three Sue, both of those are level 6. I run three of the Hieratic Seal of Sun Dragon Overlord. That's level 8. And two blue eyes, also level 8. And then I run, you know, one Ra, which is level 10. One Phoenix, Immortal Phoenix, which is level 10. And two Sphere Modes with level 10. So, though I am happy I thought of a pot of Avarice, even though I kind of deadhand it. It's dead early game, and it kind of makes me swap my playstyle a bit, but when I get Immortal Phoenix in Graveyard, and I can force Immortal Phoenix to the board with a couple of board destruction effects, and then before, you know, it goes to Sphere Mode, I will just activate that and put the Winged Dragon of Ra back into the deck, so the Sphere Mode that comes out from Immortal Phoenix can summon that again. Because that's the one thing they overlooked, is that Sphere Mode cannot summon the Winged Dragon of Ra from... It can summon it from hand or deck, but not from
the
graveyard.
Graveyard.
Which is, again, another thing that Winged Dragon of Ra is supposed to do. Because if I could do that, I would never deadhand into the Winged Dragon of Ra, ever. I would be able to discard it at will for like stuff like Graceful Charity or Sun Dragon Overlord of Heliopolis. And it would be alright. Like, I could ditch it as easily as I would Phoenix Mode, and I wouldn't have to worry about running Pot of freaking Avarice, and I could just keep the loop as it is, and it's a good loop, it's hard to break, but it's raw. He was supposed to be the strongest of the god cards, and now it's like the pyramid's turning on its side. Obelisk can, heck no, it's not a pyramid of power anymore, it's just a stack, it's raw on the bottom, depending on which way you use him, then Obelisk, just because he can't be targeted on his own, and then Slifer, holy crap, they made Slifer amazing.
Well, I think maybe that's just because it was the god card Yugi used.
Yeah, I think that's it, but by the show's lore, Ra was the strongest.
Yeah, Ra is the king of the heavens.
Yeah, in Yu-Gi-Oh! R, he had to use Divine Evolution to shift the pyramid's power so he could beat the Wicked Avatar version of Ra.
Yeah, so Obelisk the Tormentor became
Obelisk the
Progenitor. And that's how he got the cool tattoos we saw him in Season 5.
Yeah, and that's why the first printing of a legal playable Obelisk was that art.
Yep.
So, any closing thoughts here?
All it took was one of Takahashi Sensei's assistants to explain it when he made that awesome series. Oh no, I'm having that nightmare again! where Peg is a protege, blames me for his master's death, and kidnaps Taya. Also, something something wicked god cards. And Bandy Keith is a zombie! But other than that, I find this all to be quite an amazing haul. I mean, we got, like, over 10 super rares. Yes, we've got...
I got literally every cipher out of the set.
Well, yeah, we definitely got 24 rares, because, you know, guaranteed rare every pack. But then we got, like...
Ultras and Supers and all that.
Ultras and Supers. Goes out the wazoo.
We didn't pull a secret, though. Which, I mean, honestly, the secrets here aren't too important. The thing that makes me mad about Konami secrets is... The stuff, like, back when they printed the first Red Eyes, like, the cards of the Red Jewel, I think that was actually a Super Ultra, but it was the Black Stone of Legend, and for Dark Illusion, Dark Magical Circle and Magician Navigation. They're all engines in those archetypes that they said, hey, this is the pack where we get those archetypes, but they make them all secret rare, so they're so, buying them is incredibly expensive, and pulling them is impossible. Because they're all secrets. That makes... Konami, why would you make the engine of a playable deck a secret rare? That's not even subtle, you want money.
We've got to have money. But speaking of money, I think this is all pretty much a good haul.
Yeah, I mean, for $50, you save, what, 15, 18 bucks?
More like 30.
Yeah. It's gonna be 80 bucks. Really?
Yeah, the boxes are now getting a lot more expensive.
Wow.
Hopefully good things should come to those who wait, and...
Speaking of those who wait, come on, February!
Yeah, Raging Tempest will be coming soon. Hopefully we'll be getting more unboxings. And hopefully...
Well, we're definitely going to have more content between then.
Oh yeah, like, this Friday is definitely going to be the start of my playthrough on Pokemon Moon version.
I am going to try to scramble to a store and throw money at GameStop or someone to get Pokemon Sun.
Don't forget to get Genesect, because this is last mythical we're getting.
When does that end?
End of the month.
I need to go to GameStop. One I always missed was Genesect. No, we get one more. Meloetta.
December. Strangely, though, Meloetta comes before Genesect in the Pokedex.
Whatever.
Alright.
I think it was released last.
Yeah, but anyways, we'll have more content for you soon. Hope you like, feel free to subscribe, drop a comment. Please drop a comment, we love the love. And for now, this is Jeremy X and Aaron, signing off.
See ya!